Nick with Big Iron Cycles and Fabrications. I'm coming to you today with a quick video on the Wanderer here, my mid-60s Huffy Monza GT. Picked it up a couple weeks ago and, well, getting back into riding shape. Now this bike, I've already went through, tore it all apart, greased everything, got a new chain on it, new tubes, wheels have been trued. So the last few things we really got to do to it is swap out these old 50-something year old dry rotted tires. I think they're Wingfoots from, I want to say Goodyear? Yeah, Goodyear. We're going to be swapping out these old dry rotted tires for a brand new set of 26 by 175 Sunlight White Walls. So I guess without further ado, let's get started. All right, I went ahead and got a few things prepped on the bike. Went ahead and let the air out of the inner tubes. Got some tools set up, so we're ready to get started. All right, so the front on the Monza is just 9/16. So I've already had this thing torn apart a few times. So everything's relatively loosened up already, so we don't have to worry too much about trying to get things, you know, off. There we go. Gotta undo the nuts and pull the support for the front rack and the fender off. And we'll have this front tire free, well, front wheel assembly free. First one's off just like that. Always go ahead and put the nuts back on that way so we don't lose those nor the washer. Alright, we'll go ahead and set that right there. Then we'll move on to the back. Now the back is a 11/16, I think. Yeah, 11/16. Once again, I've already had those off, so they're relatively easy to get off. Let's go ahead and drop that and drop our chain. Yeah, like, set that down so it doesn't disturb me, that gorgeous, gorgeous rust that we have on there. All right, back tire's off. Now we get the fun part. Got the old tire levels out. Levers, not levels. Don't pay attention to that. So we'll just go ahead and pop one of those bad boys in there and get it hooked. All right. Well, it's a little bit difficult if my pants weren't so damn slick. Still in frame. All right, there we go. Go ahead and push our valve stem through the hole. All right, first inner tube out. And just like that, first old broke down rotten tire out. Probably really can't see the cracks on that, but she's pretty crusty. Let's see. Yeah, you see where some of the treads even popped off of it. Let's toss that over to the side. Go ahead and get our new one. Now this is a 26 by 175 from Sunlight. It's a white wall. Some of you guys are probably laughing at me right now. Man, this kid has no idea what he's doing. Eh, you're partially correct. Alright, there we go. First one is on. Now what I like to do, and personally this is just my own thing, get a nice little Schrader valve removal tool. We'll just go ahead and take that Schrader valve completely out, that way so we can get this old, still slightly aired up inner tube pretty flat. I'd also recommend wearing safety glasses when you do this, because these things will fly, and they will fly pretty hardcore. There we go. Squeeze that out a little bit. I'm gonna drop my Schrader valve. Alright, now we're good. I'm gonna put that Schrader valve back in. Okay, now we are ready. Now we gotta locate the hole for the valve, which is right there. Just not realized. Go ahead and get one bead of this. Well, at least attempt to get one bead of this tire out. There we go. Perfect. Alright, gotta find our hole again. There she is. We'll just slide that valve straight on through. Personally, what I like to do is I'll take the valve stem cap, which is kind of hard to see because my lighting is not great, and just go ahead and throw that back on there. That way, so when we're putting this inner tube fully back in, it won't pull through. That way, so we don't have to fight that again. Go ahead and feed her on into the tire. Not realize you can't see that on screen. My apologies. Still kind of new at making YouTube videos. Don't worry, they will get better. At least I hope. So we'll continue tucking that tube up into the tire. That way she doesn't get caught in the bead. Only bad part about working on bikes, just trying to remount tires. Alright, first one, all mounted up. We'll get some marinette here in a little bit. First, we got to move on to that front. And if you're still watching and you think you'd want to see some more of this train wreck, you can go ahead and leave a comment, hit like, subscribe if you want. If you don't, it's whatever. I'll live. No, bad. Don't do as I say or I do. Alright, second tire off. This one slightly worse than the other one. You can see where tire's starting to crack and peel, and it's not very good. Not much tread left on anyways. And yes, I did actually ride it for a week like this. Oh yeah, there we go. There's a good one. I don't know if you can see that because of the crappy lighting, but there we go. All right, that one in the trash. All right, go ahead and do the same thing all over again. Hole go. There it is. All right, once again, pull it beat out a little bit, find your hole.
I should probably watch the phrasing.
See, I think we are now at 13 minutes of me struggling, but learning experience. That's what YouTube's all about.
Then cat videos.
A lot of cat videos. That's where the real money's to be made at. Not in fixing bikes on YouTube. Making cat videos. Being drunk, making cat videos. Getting your cat drunk and making videos. Pardon me, lost my mind for a second. All right, second tire and air tube all mounted up. Let's see if we can't just get that tube to straighten up a little bit. I'll tell you what, that's just going to be close enough. There we go. All right, I'll see you guys here in a little bit because I've got to turn on this noisy-ass compressor and I don't want to ruin your day with that. Like, I've probably already ruined your day watching this video. All right, now since my worn-out old air compressor is damn good and warmed up and making my basement smell like motor oil, we'll go ahead and get these tires thrown back on. We'll get them aired up and she'll be ready to ride. So, if you hadn't guessed, basically putting the tires back on is just taking them off in reverse. So we're just going to do exactly that. Slide the front one in. Does kind of suck doing this by yourself, because really could use some help, but oh well, it's fine. Right, there's one side on. Second one. I get done with this, and I'll do this off camera. But I'll go ahead and make sure that this wheel's all straightened up inside these forks, and after that, well, we'll be able to take it out for a cruise. This is going to be one of my daily modes of transportation to and from work. Luckily, I live like a block away, so something this uncomfortable. Really not that big of a deal. Give her a little bit of a snug, not too much, just enough. All right, there we go. There's the first one on. The back one's a little bit more fun. So especially because, you know, you have to contend with the coaster brake and all the washers and the chain. But we'll be all right. We'll get through. We'll live. Maybe. Those damn commie ghosts don't get us. Back one's fairly good and lined up. Trying to get our coaster brake all done up proper. Oh, well, I guess it'd help if I actually have that chain on there proper. There we go. That's better. This is why it'd be nice to have quick releases on these. It is such a pain in the ass trying to do this by yourself in a basement. Alright. Slide the coaster brake bracket back in place. Get this put back together and we'll be done. There we go. It'd be nice if I could actually see what I was doing. That's one thing I wish I would have thought of before I bought this bench mount bike repair stand. It's because it really, granted, it takes up a lot less room than your standard bike repair stand. But holy crap, you have essentially no room on the other side to work. Alright. Snip that back in there because I didn't grab the right wrench. We'll be back. Alright, we're back. Got the right tools this time. Hopefully. We're just going to see how it goes. Now, see, this was not the brightest idea. Granted, having this bike work stand or repair stand to work on, super nice. Like, looks a little bit more professional, you know, that way, so I'm not, you know, flopping my bike over and over and over to just, you know, change tires or inner tubes or whatever. But huge drawback, it being mounted to a bench. It's the biggest issue. Alright, we're still looking good and straight. Alright. Now we're ready for a little bit of air. Using my nice little Cornwell digital gauge here. Get that valve cap off. Huh. Wow. Okay, that's cool. Something I didn't notice, but, well, you can't see it either because of the lighting, but this valve cap actually has a Schrader valve removal tool. Never seen one of those before. Some of you guys probably seen that and are yelling at me, but I never seen one. Oh, I didn't know. Right. It's the only bad thing about doing this. Air tool doesn't necessarily have the best tip on it, so it just kind of comes off. And we're gonna put a little bit more in there. We're gonna crank her up to 45. Really? Tell you what, right there, we're good. Set at 45. Put my valve cap back on. All right, there's one tire good and ready to go. No bulges, and she's rolling straight. All right, I'm gonna do the front. Dragged the little blue compressor of death out a little bit, so I have a little bit more room to work with. Get this cap off. We're good, sit at 45. Now, it says recommended set it to like 40, but I set it at 45 because, well, I don't know if you can tell, but I'm kind of fat, so gotta take up a little bit of that extra weight. Hopefully, riding my bike back and forth to work this summer, hopefully I won't be this fat anymore, so yeah. Well, I think we're pretty much done with this video. I mean, you know, pretty simple and straightforward, although with all my struggling, you wouldn't be able to tell, but, I digress. Still new to the YouTube video making, especially actually being on camera. Some of my old videos where I'm not on camera, not so bad. So, as a recap, new tires and tubes on the Monza GT, 50-something-year-old bike. Only paid $120 for it. And honestly, pretty damn cool bike. I really like it. Love the jet age styling. Now, this bike is pretty much going to be left in the present condition that it's in, because I like the rat rod style. You know, it's, this bike's been around for a while, and you know what? There's nothing wrong with showing a little bit of age. Probably one thing I will do, and that will be the next video, is we will start shining up some of this chrome. Now it's pretty rusty and pitty, but once again, as long as she shines up a little bit, you know, it's not ever going to be a show bike. It's never going to be a show winner. It's going to be a fun cruise around town kind of bike. Go to the bars, local burger joint, ride it to work. So basically, for all I want it for, she'll do just fine. All right, well, this has been Nick, and hey, I'll catch you all in the next one. See ya.